My name is Jess Hegedus and I'm an anaesthetist in Wollongong and a member of the ANZCA Environmental Sustainability Working Group. Recently, I had the pleasure of collaborating with Associate Professor Kerstin Wyssusek on an article for the upcoming ANZCA Bulletin addressing some of the challenges to environmental sustainability during the COVID-19 pandemic and how these might be addressed. Kerstin is the Director of the Department of Anaesthesia at the Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital and an Associate Professor at the Uni of Queensland. She recently received the Individual Award for Outstanding Achievement in the Queensland Health Awards for Excellence due to her long-standing contribution to environmentally sustainable healthcare practice, both in her institution and through her research. We are extremely fortunate to have Kerstin share her knowledge and experience as a member of the Environmental Sustainability Working Group. And we thought it'd be great to explore some of her thoughts on sustainability to provide some insight to ANZCA fellows and trainees looking to improve environmental sustainability in their own practice. So thank you, Kerstin, for taking the time to chat.
Thank you.
Firstly, I'd love to know what motivated you to get involved in activities to promote environmental sustainability in operating theatres?
Thank you for the introduction, Jess. Very much appreciate it. My journey started in about 2009 when I moved to another hospital where there was literally no waste segregation happening at all in the operating theatre. And everything was disposed of into clinical waste only, which is not only more expensive, as we know, but traditionally it gets incinerated, which has a huge impact on the environment. So that bothered me and I started asking questions. And through that, a core group of like-minded people formed, and we started very simple with basic waste segregation principles, and then soon that was followed by recycling.
So a lot of your research discusses the problem of waste in operating theatres. Why is waste such an important issue in theatres, and where do you see the most waste occurring in anaesthetic practice?
Very important question, Jessica, and I believe most people, clinicians, do not know that the largest waste producer in a hospital is actually the operating theatre complex. We produce up to 30% of the total hospital waste. And to get waste management right in our environment will have a huge impact on an organisation, but more importantly for the environment. And a second part of your question, occurring waste in anaesthetic practices, I think I like to divide this into two main categories. So one is the visible waste we deal with every day, and then there's a little bit of an invisible waste component we have as anaesthetists. So the most common waste products we end up with in the operating theatre, which often still end up in general waste and get disposed of, are recyclable products just like paper, cardboard, Kimguard, and hard plastics. And I would like to encourage everyone to combine efforts with all the theatre staff, like our scrub nurses, the anaesthetic assistants, and the surgeons, as I think in the operating theatre, most waste is actually generated by the scrub side, and combine efforts to start recycling activities should be a group exercise. And the more invisible waste in our craft group is or are the anaesthetic gases. They have a very high carbon dioxide equivalent over 20 years, which is the CDE20, you may have heard that. This is the amount of heat trapped in a gas over 20 years. I think that's quite astonishing. Did you know, Jess, that volatile gases remain in the atmosphere for up to 15 years? So the CDE20 for sevoflurane is about 440, and that of desflurane is 6,810. So the carbon footprint of desflurane is 15 times higher than that of sevoflurane. So there's a lot of things we can do as anaesthetists to support the environment and to actually reduce our carbon footprint. And one of my more recent research projects is concerned with sustainability and packaging in the operating theatre. So we recently published an article in our surgical journal, actually alerting surgeons to the waste we are producing, particularly plastics, in packaging single-use surgical instruments. And we hope to find a strategy to separate those plastics at source but also to get buy-in from the producers of those packagings to take responsibility for recycling their own products.
All right, so you wrote a review article last year looking at greening initiatives in operating theatres, which outlined some creative things that healthcare professionals had done to reduce the impact of their waste. What is the most innovative idea that you've heard or read about regarding how waste can be reused or repurposed in the health setting?
Well, luckily, there's lots of creative people amongst healthcare workers, and some very innovative strategies involve even artwork. And the ANZCA Bulletin has reported on some artworks done by anaesthetists using those coloured plastic lids from our medication vials. And also donating Kimguard to the RSPCA or collecting copper from the diathermy leads are very innovative and creative ideas. The most impact, however, I think, are having schemes which are organised on a larger scale. And we know that Kimguard and PVC recycling schemes are those ones who are very successful and have been implemented in many hospitals. And I'd like to take the opportunity here to thank Forbes McGain, who's an anaesthetist from Melbourne, who actually initiated the PVC recycling scheme in collaboration with Baxter and the Vinyl Council of Australia. And I would like that all anaesthetists get their hospital managers to sign up for that scheme.
As I mentioned earlier, you and I have written an article for the upcoming bulletin regarding issues around environmental sustainability in the COVID-19 pandemic and how trainees and fellows can continue to engage in greening activities during this time. What is your advice for people who are struggling to maintain sustainability in their workplaces during this difficult period?
First of all, I think we would like to invite everyone to read the ANZCA Bulletin article, which is coming out very soon, as it summarises its general waste management practices and highlights specifics in times of a pandemic. But most importantly, it advises us to continue with current waste management strategies while we're very busy and occupied with other issues. We have to remain vigilant to continue according to hospital waste management guidelines and strategies. Although it's very obvious at the moment that we are producing much more infectious waste and plastics, which unfortunately we may not be able to recycle. But to observe any publications related to COVID-19 activities in your hospital would be very important, and to follow those. Although if you have concerns about practices or breaches of protocols or infection control guidelines, then please speak up and find like-minded people to address the issues. But above all, just remain inquisitive and creative. Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to share your expertise in this area and for the contribution that you've made to environmental sustainability in anaesthesia. It's been really wonderful to chat. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good day.